rebuilding a Tangi model steam engine part 10, milling the deep slot in the crosshead. I need to mark out the part, so for this I'm using some marking out fluid, and this was kindly sent to me by a man called Norman, who also later on sent me some red stuff as well. The only thing I don't like about this marking out fluid is the brush is too stiff, and even though I wipe the brush thoroughly on the inside of the cap, I still put too much on. But I suppose it's really designed for much larger parts than these. In this clip, I'm using the very thin steel rule that I bought from RDG Tools to mark the position of the slot. And what's the slot for? Well, it's to take the small end of the connecting rod, so it has to be a deep slot. I marked out the component in the table vise that I bought, which is very handy. On screen at the moment is a shot of the collet chuck of my Proxon EF70 milling machine. It's very small, very powerful and very useful. And it's fitted with a Proxon milling cutter. This is not a slot drill, but I want to see whether it does the job. The crosshead itself is made from phosphor bronze, so I'm hoping that this very small milling machine, with its equally small milling cutter, is actually going to be capable of cutting this deep slot all the way down into the crosshead. So far so good, but there's a long way to go yet. I'm using a paintbrush to remove the chippings. I could have used my larger milling machine for this job, and used a 3/16 of an inch diameter milling cutter, but I thought I would put the Proxon EF70 through its paces. In case you're wondering why the milling machine is moving about, that's because the milling machine is screwed to a substantial piece of wood, and it's the piece of wood that's moving about. I often take liberties with milling machines. I start off by winding the handle slowly, but eventually I start to wind the handle too fast as I get a bit impatient as to why it's taking so long to cut such a small piece of metal. There's a hole all the way through the crosshead, part of which is threaded to take the piston rod. I've lowered the milling cutter down into this hole to take a deeper cut, just to see what happens. The only experience I've had using this Proxon EF70 was to machine some dummy brass brake blocks for the Hogwarts Express project. I will be carrying on with that shortly as soon as the weather gets warmer. I need to paint it, but unfortunately I paint near the door and it's just too cold. In this clip, I've increased the speed of the machine and I'm taking a very heavy cut at too high a speed. And for this, I'm rewarded by the cutter breaking, but not where you would expect it to break. The cutter broke where it entered the collet. So I just removed the broken part and refitted the cutter, and here I am carrying on, but I did use a different collet. I noticed that the collet that I was using was a little bit oversized. That's possibly why it broke. I have a very delicate touch. Really, I should have been a gynecologist, but in this case, I'm brutalizing this machine because I really want to see what it's capable of and what its limitations are. And if everything goes wrong, what's wasted? I just have to make a new crosshead, which is a very simple part. It's a piece of 9/16 phosphor bronze bar, cut to length, with a hole drilled down the middle and partially threaded, and a flat milled on one side, so all would not be lost. But if I spent time machining this part and it was a complicated one, I wouldn't be quite so flippant. I noticed that the cutter's cutting much better in this smaller, tighter collet, so I'm really applying the pressure. Oh dear, the end of the cutter's broken off. I think I've definitely found the limit of the machine's capabilities. Luckily, I have some more cutters, so I fitted a new one and carried on. This time, I'm treating both the machine and the cutter with a little bit more respect. As I said right at the beginning of this video, really, I should have used my main milling machine, because this milling cutter is a bit too small for the job. I'm having to do multi-passes up and down the slot to widen it, but it's working out okay, and the finish is quite good. And that's the job just about done. The slot is more than deep enough and wide enough. And in this clip, you can see why I needed this deep slot in the crosshead to take the small end of the connecting rod. Using a piece of 400 grit wet-to-dry sandpaper on the bench, I'm cleaning up the front face of the crosshead to remove the burrs. And as you can see from the camera angle here, it's looking good. The crosshead is fitted into the drilling machine and I'm drilling the crosshole. This will take a pin that holds the small end to the crosshead itself. As always, I start off with a centre drill, followed by a drill one imperial size under the size that I want, and this hole needs to be 9/64 of an inch in diameter. I'm now drilling all the way through the crosshead using a drill bit that is 1/8 of an inch in diameter. And in this clip, back on the bench, I'm tapping the reverse side 4BA, making sure that the tap is perfectly aligned. And after reaming the hole at the other side 9/64 of an inch, I'm fitting a 4BA bolt. And I'm only fitting this bolt to make sure everything goes together, which it does. And the other good thing is the head of this bolt is quite large, so I'm scribing around it. I've applied more marking out blue, and I'm scratching the rough shape of the finished crosshead into the marking out blue. I'll be making a proper crosshead pin for the finished article, but for now the bolt suffices, so I can check the travel and the size of the crosshead. The crosshead's pulling out too much, so in the next episode when I shape the crosshead, I will make sure I shorten this part of it. The other end of the crosshead can't go fully up to the cylinder because the crosshead nut is in the way. But it won't be when I make the crosshead into its final shape. The main thing is, everything is in good alignment. As I say frequently, it's not too tight and it's not too slack, and that's not a girlfriend joke. In the next episode, I'll finish the crosshead, put the piston in place, check all the travels, then the engine will be ready for painting, followed by reassembly and running. That's it for this one though. Thanks for watching, and I hope you found it useful.